Hi, I'm Quentin Schultze, professor of communication, emeritus, which means I'm quote-unquote retired, even though I still do teaching and everything else. But I'm also author of the book, Communicate Like a True Leader. Communicate Like a True Leader. It's based on the servant leadership principles of Robert Greenleaf. And I developed the field of servant communication, kind of parallel to servant leadership. And I want to start out with a topic here that is so important, and that is compromise. Compromise. When should we compromise? Or even, is compromise a good thing? You know, I meet people who tell me they will never compromise on anything. And I wonder about that. How well do they get along with other people? And if they lead an organization or a department or a division, and they never compromise on anything, I wonder what the people who work under them feel about them. Because compromise is very important. In fact, there is freedom for all of us in compromise. That's not to say that compromise in and of itself should dictate everything we do. So here's a quote from Robert Greenleaf, the founder of the field of servant leadership, on compromise. Listen closely to this. It's wonderful. Compromise makes life on earth possible, with normal human beings living in relative freedom. Compromise makes life possible, and it gives us the ability as normal human beings to live in relative freedom. That's Bob Greenleaf on compromise. Think of compromise not as total agreement, but as agreement on certain things, okay? That's the best way to think about a healthy compromise. Over the years in teaching my students about when to compromise, how to compromise, and then with the mentoring of my former students now for 45 years, and they will call me up on the phone and say, I've got a real problem here, there's something, and I don't want to compromise on it, what do you think? And we chat about it. And a good mentor, of course, just asks questions and helps them decide what to do. But I would say to my students, don't start at compromise. Start with this consideration. What are your non-negotiables? What are your non-negotiables? In other words, what are the things that you cannot compromise on? We all have some things in our lives that we will not compromise on, and we shouldn't compromise on. Often these are root values or beliefs, and we are not going to waver on those. Sometimes they have to do with ethical principles. I will not go over this line, we say to ourselves. So these are kind of absolutes that I call non-negotiables. And then everything outside of those absolutes we can consider for our lives as leaders, as well as just human beings, to be negotiable. So it's that whole realm of the negotiable where we compromise with other people. And we don't necessarily, in the end, fully agree with those that we compromise with. But because we are compromising in the arena of the negotiables, excuse me if I confused you on that, the negotiables, then we have not abrogated our own responsibility to be true to ourselves and to live with integrity. You see, integrity. So I have another video on integrity. Please watch it. But we're whole. We're integral. Our lives are together. We know what we believe and what we value, and we live that out. We live with integrity. This is who we are. And we're not going to change ourselves for the whims of here and there and another person or whatever it is on those non-negotiables. So it's helpful for me always in the situations that I find myself to determine whether or not I should compromise on something. Here's an interesting story about this. One of my practices as a professor that I developed over the years was that I would send the syllabus for my courses. The syllabus lists what the readings are, or videos they have to watch, what the requirements are, how class will be run, how I will grade, and what my grading rubrics will be, the criteria that I use for grading and all. I will send that out in advance, usually a week before the class begins, assuming I have a list of the students that will be in the class. And I ask them in an email to read through it, because I say when we get to class, we're not only going to go over that syllabus, but we are going to determine if we can agree on it. And students are a little perplexed on that, because typically they don't have that happening with their other courses. And we get there for that first day and we're going over things, and I say, now, does anyone have any concerns? Does anyone see anything that we can improve in this syllabus? Maybe a way that I'm being unfair, or maybe the schedule is such that it interferes with other important campus events. Often, students, having looked at that syllabus in advance, looked at my email, wondering if I am really going to compromise at all on anything on a syllabus, will raise a question, humbly, rightfully so, I'm the professor, and say, well, what about this? I don't exactly understand this assignment, and I wonder if we could do it differently. And then they raise something, and we have a discussion about it, and I might change. I might say, okay, let's negotiate on this. Let's do a little compromising, because often some of the students in the class will agree and some of the students won't agree with the change, and we have to decide whether or not we can compromise on something. So compromise is something that we think of as wrong, as a kind of dirtiness, unethical. Don't compromise yourself. But actually, we have to do it all the time as part of life. And the real question is, do we stay away from compromising on those things which we need for our integrity? Because they are the non-negotiables. And every organization, including the one that you might be a leader of, should have some statements as to what's negotiable and not within that organization. Basic non-negotiables in terms of its vision, in terms of its operating procedures and the like, although some of those might get changed over time through compromise. Compromise can be a really, really good thing, because it can invest more people in a sense of ownership of the organization if they have some input that leads to a good compromise. But then the people who feel like the decisions that you might have made are not in tune with what they want and they believe, then they have to also be addressed in some way. And sometimes you may even have to go to some of them personally and say, I know you didn't agree with our compromise on this, and I just want you to know that I heard you, but this is the way we're headed now, and I hope you'll stay with it and give it a try. Because after all, in the end, you, might be wrong too, but let's move forward together with this compromise. Greenleaf is amazing when he relates compromise to freedom, because it gives us freedom to not make everything in life a non-negotiable, so that we would become the kind of person that demands that everything be done the way we want. Those persons are impossible to work with. And we've all had those experiences. They make everything into a non-negotiable, and often they have to be let go, and they have to move on in their lives. Thank you so much for watching this. I hope you'll take an interest in my book, Communicate Like a True Leader. I'll put a link down below to Amazon. It's an inexpensive book, and you can pick up a copy and write me a note about it. Any notes down below, subscribe to this channel. And also, if you want to get in touch with me personally, if there's some way I can serve you or your organization, go to my website, quentinschultze.com. You can get my personal email there and fire me a note. I respond personally to every email I get in a timely fashion. And thank you. I hope you figure out the ways in your life to compromise the best without going against your non-negotiables, so that you have both freedom and integrity.